Praise the Lord. Welcome to Emmanuel Christian Center Facebook Live. This is our Wednesday night service, and we welcome you. We're going to start with Psalms 103. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeems thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfy thy mouth with good things, so that the youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord executeth righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. He made known his ways unto Moses, his acts unto the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and plenteous in mercy. He will not always chide, neither will he keep his anger forever. He hath not dealt with us after our sin, nor rewarding us according to our iniquities. For as the heaven is high above the earth, so great is his mercy toward them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far he hath he removed our transgressions from us. Like a father that pitieth his children, so the Lord pitieth them that fear him. That means that God's mercy endureth forever. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your mercy, Lord. We know that your word says goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. So we plead the blood of Jesus tonight. We thank you, Lord, that you surround us as a shield. We receive the protection of an almighty God. God bless you. Welcome to service tonight. Please lift your hands at home and say praise the Lord as our pastor comes, Pastor Alvin Simpkins.
Praise ye the Lord. The Lord is good. Welcome to the house of the Lord. Welcome. God is a good God. He loves you, and everything is going to be all right. Thank the Lord for his grace and all of his favor tonight, and we just honor him. Take your Bible and go with me to Psalms 103. Psalms 103. Psalms 103. We want to talk tonight about the attitude of gratitude, that you ought to be thankful and appreciative of all that God has done for you. Verse 1 says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercy, who satisfies thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagle. So, Father, we just thank you for your word tonight. May your word be a blessing into our lives. Let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our heart, may it be acceptable in your sight on this night. In Jesus' name I pray. Somebody say amen. Amen. It's good to be here tonight. God is a good God. Don't forget to share the video. Call somebody. Tell them to watch. We're going to be praying for you. We're going to be encouraging you. And we're going to do all that we can to make sure that you get through what you're going through, because the Lord is on your side. The Lord is on your side. As we talk tonight about an attitude of gratitude, how that we must be grateful, how much we must be appreciative, and all for all that God has done in our lives. As we look tonight as developing an attitude of gratitude, and now we have to know that these are tough times in America. We have to know that that God loves us, and that we live in a fallen world, and bad things happen to good people, and we have to know that the Lord is still good. If you've had losses in your life from COVID-19, we certainly pray for you, and we are so sorry for your loss. God bless you, and may his face shine upon you in the days ahead. If your loved one is sick and in the hospital, we are praying for them and believing for God's best. You know, but now is the time to pray and have an attitude of gratitude and appreciate everything that you have. You know, you have to look back at your yesterdays and appreciate what the Lord has done for you and your family. Thank you. Somebody just say, thank you. Oh, you got to appreciate. Now is the time for us to be there for each other, to stand by one another. Here at Emmanuel Christian Center, we do life together. Somebody put that on the screen and let the redeemer of the Lord say so. We do life together. This is one of the most difficult times in America, in the history of America. And so we don't know where it's going to end, but we know that God loves us. And we know that we'll get through this only together. And we must do all that we can and within our power to meet the moment of this crisis with faith, with togetherness, with gratitude, with a heart of appreciation and heartfelt prayers for the people that we love. This is the hour to pray. You got to pray now. Somebody say, pray now. You got to pray now. We must recognize and vocalize our gratitude. We must, one, recognize. Number two, vocalize our gratitude and our appreciation. And we got to tell God how much we appreciate all that he is doing in our lives. Gratefulness and gratitude are deep emotional feelings. We must be grateful. And we must have gratitude for what the Lord has done in our lives. We are grateful because of his goodness, his mercy, and all of his grace. Somebody say, just be grateful. Oh, just be grateful. Things could have turned out a lot worse than they are. But because you love the Lord and because you pray and trust in God, you know the Lord worked it out. David said in Psalm 124, if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, oh, he said, I would have never made it. And so tonight we want you to know that gratefulness and gratitude and appreciation is what moves the very heart of God. We must start our day with a heart of gratitude. We must do all that we can to tell God, I am grateful that I'm still alive. All of us know of somebody that did not make it. You're watching me tonight here at Facebook Live. All of us know of somebody that did not make it. We must be grateful and we must appreciate God. And we have to always say, I'll not forget all your benefits over my life. A grateful heart, worship God from the depths of the soul and the deep recesses of the inner man. Gratefulness is important. Gratefulness and gratitude is what is important to God. And we must do all that we can to pray against the spirit of ungratefulness. We must do all that we can to tell God, I appreciate. Oh, I appreciate all that you have done in my life. Is there anybody out there that appreciate what the Lord has done? Is there anybody out there that know the Lord helped you when you couldn't help yourself? Is there anybody out there know that the Lord has been good for you and he's been good to you? So you must be grateful. Somebody say grateful. Don't take it for granted that you have a house. Don't take it for granted that you have a car. Don't take it for granted that you might not have a house or a car, but you got a roof over your head. And you have hope in tomorrow. Don't take it for granted. Just be grateful. Be grateful. Be grateful. Pastor, I had a man ask me, what's the difference between gratefulness, gratitude, and thanksgiving? Well, give me a minute. Gratitude and gratefulness and is so different from thanksgiving. Gratitude is a feeling that we have in our heart, our mind, and our spirit. Oh, I am grateful. Woo! It stirs the love of God in our heart. Oh, it ignites our feelings. It fuels our appreciation for God. Gratefulness and gratitude. Lord, I am grateful. It fills your heart with an energy of appreciation. Gratefulness and gratitude causes us to have a heart of appreciation and celebration. We can celebrate. When we are grateful, we are generous. When we are grateful, it makes our heart healthy, it makes our lives healthy, and it lifts our spirit. When we are grateful, when we have an attitude of gratitude, and when we appreciate all that God has for us, it embodies our whole soul that we are grateful. It tells God how you feel about him and his blessing. Lord, I'm grateful Woo, I appreciate you. I celebrate you. It is declaring our allegiance to the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. I am grateful. And it cries out from the depths of my heart. I'm grateful. I appreciate. And I have a heart of gratitude. Thanksgiving is totally different. Don't get them confused. They're two separate. They are two wings of the same bird. Thanksgiving demands action. Thanksgiving demands. Gratefulness just say, oh, I appreciate you, I love you, and I celebrate you. It's just telling God. But when we say thank you, it demands action. Oh, we have to do something. When you tell God, Lord, I thank you, then you ought to do something. You ought to do something. Somebody say, do something. Thanksgiving demands that we do something. It demands that we do something. You remember the young man, the 10 lepers that Jesus healed? He healed 10 lepers, and they went on their way, hopping and skipping. They were so grateful. They were so appreciative. They had such a heart of gratitude. But one said, oh, wait a minute. And the Bible said he turned around and went back to Jesus with a thankful heart. See, thanksgiving demands that you do something. Oh, somebody say, do something. It demands that, it says that the action said, I owe you, Lord, because you've been good to me. The action said, I'm going to come boldly back to you and tell you thank you, that I'm going to give you praise when I don't want to give you praise, because I'm thankful and I appreciate all that you have done. It demands that I open my mouth with a heart of thanksgiving. See, gratefulness, gratitude, and appreciation on this hand comes from the heart and the spirit. Oh, I love you. I appreciate you. But then thankfulness, woo, it comes from a heart of action. Faith without works is what? Dead. Men, don't tell your wife that you're thankful for them and don't do nothing for them. You got to do something. Thanksgiving demands that you do something. Somebody put on the screen, do something. Demands that we open our mouths and give God praise. Don't worry about what people say. Don't worry about how they look at you. Just give him praise anyway. Oh, I praise you. I praise you. I praise you. Because I'm thankful, so I got to do something. Somebody say, do something. No pride in our lives live when we have a thankful heart. It demands that we have a heart of humility. And we must recognize and vocalize our gratitude for our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The children of Israel, they were ungrateful. They were unappreciative. They did not have a heart of gratitude, and they certainly didn't have a heart of thanksgiving. They always complained about God. They always said negative things about God. They never recognized and vocalized the gratitude in their hearts for God or for Moses. And that's the way some people are. They never recognize and they never vocalize their love for our Lord and Jesus Christ. And they certainly don't do anything for the kingdom of God. But when you are thankful and when you have a heart of appreciation and when you are thankful, you have to do something. Faith without works is what? Dead. Tonight I want to talk with you about gratitude and appreciation. That it will bless your life. It will help you. Be thankful that you are still alive. Be grateful. Be appreciative that you did not die of COVID-19. Tomorrow is not promised. So today you ought to be grateful. You ought to be grateful. You ought to be grateful. Somebody say grateful. The children of Israel were never grateful. So one day God got tired of them. They were complaining about Moses. And God said, Moses, I heard them talking bad about me, not being grateful, not being appreciative. And he said, I'm done with them. He said in Numbers 14:28, say unto them, as truly as you have spoken it in my ears, that's exactly what I'm going to do in your life. They were ungrateful. They said, we're going to die in the wilderness. And they died, all of them, in the wilderness. See, you got to be grateful. And you got to say something. Let the redeemed of the Lord, what? Say something. You got to say something. You got to tell God what an awesome God is. You got to tell him how big he is. Because I'm appreciative and I'm grateful. You got to tell him what how big he is. There's no one like you, Lord. David loved God. And he was always appreciative of the Lord. Down through the Psalms. You see where David celebrated God. You see where David blessed God. He said in Psalms 103, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his holy name. Let me say to you through the word of the Lord tonight, be appreciative of what God has done. Be grateful for your car. Appreciate that you have a roof over your head. Thank God for all that you have. And then do something when you thank him. And be appreciative that you got people in your life that love you. Be appreciative that you have people in your life that care about you. And they have to know that God will bless you. Gratitude and gratefulness is emotional from my heart. Thanksgiving demand action. You got to do something. You got to do something. And when you are grateful, them things happen in your life. If you are grateful, you will be more empathetic and forgiving. If you are grateful, God will protect you from stress and all the things that will mess up your life. He'll help you to sleep well at night. If you are grateful and you have a heart of gratitude, woo, he'll help you to get through whatever you're going through without being depressed. If you are grateful and you have a heart of attitude, a heart of a good attitude, God will bless your life. You have long-term happiness that will come into your life. Long-term happiness that will come into your life. But I want you to know, gratitude and gratefulness is a science of pleasing God. He wants to know in your heart. Man looks on the outward appearance, but God looks at the heart. He want to know that you got a heart of gratefulness, appreciating God for all his many blessings. Oh, I appreciate you. Oh, I am grateful. Oh, I have a heart of gratitude. All of you watching me tonight, you know you can look back over your life and see where the Lord brought you from. See how he blessed your son. See how he blessed your daughter. See how he helped you in your marriage. See how he gave you a job that you didn't even qualify for. Because you know God loves us. And if God loves us, we ought to have a heart to say that I'm grateful, I appreciate you, and I celebrate you. Somebody say, I'm grateful. I'm grateful. Gratitude must be the bedrock of our faith in Jesus Christ. We must appreciate and we must find a way to celebrate all that he is in our lives. If he did it then, he'll do it again. So just be thankful. Just have a heart of gratitude, of appreciation. Appreciate all that God has in your life. And you have to know, we must tell God how much we appreciate it. We must tell God how much we are grateful for the things that he's done for us. We must tell him that I shall forever, continually let your praise be in my mouth. Because I am grateful. I am grateful. I am grateful. So you have to know that you have to, gratitude will help you. It will lift you. It will lift you. It will encourage you and others. If you get around a person that's appreciate, oh, I appreciate you for inviting me to dinner. I appreciate getting sit down and eat up everything they got. I appreciate lick the plate. Ooh, I appreciate. And then they might invite you back again. But if you come in with an attitude, ooh, this don't taste good. I put the four there. You're not going to get invited back. You're not appreciative. You're not grateful. We must have a grateful heart. Somebody say gratefulness. Let me tell you, it's one of the keys that destroys good marriages. I'll never forget the man that was not grateful for his wife. And so he didn't treat her right. And as you know, 75% of divorces are filed by women. And so she filed for a divorce. Well, some other guy came along and picked her up. Didn't call her names, didn't say anything negative about her. You know, walked with her every day so that she could slim down. And all of a sudden, one day she saw the old guy in Walmart. And he tried to hit on her. Hey, you looking good. But she said, you never appreciated me, so you ain't got nothing to say to me. So she went home and told her new husband, this guy tried to hit on. So he called him up and said, hey, man, don't be hitting on my wife. And almost started a fight. But you see, he missed out. Now they bought a new house. Woo! She was driving a new car. Woo! She was wearing a new dress. Woo! She was looking good. Woo! Somebody put on the screen. Woo! WHEW. Woo! She was looking good because he didn't appreciate her. Gratitude and appreciation and gratefulness will encourage you. It will bring peace to your life. It will bring you supernatural strength. And it will add value to your life. This new husband added value to her life. Oh, Lord, marriages ought to stay together. Men, appreciate the women in your life. Ladies, appreciate the men in your life. And then God will bless you. You got to be appreciative. You got to be grateful. And you got to have a heart of gratitude. Your altitude determines your attitude. And you got to appreciate all that God has done in your life. And don't take it for granted. You got to know the Lord. You got to be grateful that the Lord picked you up out of the muck and the miry clay. Set your feet on a rock to stay. If it had not been for the Lord who was on your side, David said in Psalm, you would have never made it. But Lord, give me a grateful heart. Raise your hand all the way out there, everybody, right where you are on your screen in your living room. Raise your hand and let's pray together. Lord, give us grateful hearts. Oh, don't let us take nothing for granted. Give us grateful heart. We declare tonight a spirit of gratefulness that will fill our lives in the name of Jesus. Thank you for the goodness and the mercy of the Lord that shall follow us all the days of our lives. Grateful. Somebody say, I am grateful. Woo, I am grateful. I'm going to trust in the Lord with all my heart. Lean not into our own understanding. Gratefulness, appreciation, and gratitude are attributes of our spirit and our heart and our mind. But we tell God how much we appreciate it. Thanksgiving, and I talk about it on Sunday. Be here on Sunday. Invite somebody. I want to talk about Thanksgiving is another track. And it deals with your ability to do something. If I am thankful, if you've touched my life and I am thankful, I'm going to do something. If somebody touched your life and you're thankful, don't just send them a card in the mail with nothing in it. Put something in it because Thanksgiving says, I got to do something. Woo! Thanksgiving says, I got to do something. Look at the neighbor and say, do something. Do something. You know, because the Lord has been good to you. The Lord heard your cry. And he pitied your every groan. And he's been faithful down through the years. Brought you when you couldn't bring yourself. Help you when everybody turned their backs on you. If I got anybody out there to know the Lord's been good to you, then you ought to say something. If the Lord gave you food to eat, if the Lord answered your prayer, if the Lord lifted up your head from crying, if the Lord healed your body, then you ought to say something. If the Lord brought you when you couldn't bring yourself, you don't know like I know what the Lord has done in our life. The Lord is good. Goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. Goodness and mercy is going to follow you. Have a grateful heart. Have an appreciative spirit. Have a grateful mind. Thank you for all your help. Somebody shout hallelujah. You come too far. You come this far by faith. You didn't get here by accident. The Lord was with you in last year. The Lord was with your children. The Lord was with your family. The Lord was with your marriage. The Lord was with your grandchildren. Thank you. I am grateful. Somebody say, I am grateful. Somebody say, I am grateful. You can't hurry God. You just have to wait. He'll always come on time. May not come when you want him. But I heard somebody say, he's always, always, always on time. He's an on-time God. So don't give up. Don't give out. Don't quit. I don't feel. No waste time. Come too far from where I started from. Nobody told us the road would be easy. But I don't believe he brought you this far to leave you. I don't believe he brought you this far to leave you. Now just put your hands together. Wherever you are, put your hands together and give the Lord a praise in Jesus' name. Somebody say hallelujah. You and your children owe the Lord gratitude, appreciation, and gratefulness. You owe the Lord. You owe the Lord gratitude. Put it on the screen. I owe the Lord. Somebody put it down there for me as a pastor. Say, I'm putting this on for pastor. I owe the Lord. I owe the Lord. Because the Lord's been good in my life. Bow your heads and let's pray together. Put it down for me, please. Put this, say, this one is for pastor. We owe the Lord. I owe the Lord. When my parents had no money to send me to college, God paid the bill. Not just at one university, but at three universities, he paid the bill. I owe the Lord gratefulness, appreciation. I owe him. You owe him too. You owe him too. Don't give up. Don't quit. And just know that you didn't come this far by faith. You got to give God the thanks. And you got to appreciate. Appreciate all that he's done in your life. And he'll bless your life. Would you raise your hands with me right where you are in your living room, in your car, in your office, where in your garage, wherever you are. Father, thank you. Give us a heart of gratitude. Give us a heart of gratefulness. Give us a heart of appreciation. In the name of Jesus. We join David. We join David when he said, if it had not been the Lord who was on my side, if it had not been the Lord who was on my side, had not been the Lord who was on our side, we would have never made it. But tonight, we declare a heart of gratefulness, of appreciation, and of gratitude. We honor you today, and we appreciate all that you are in our lives. We honor you today with grateful hearts. Oh, hearts of pride are not grateful. Hearts of arrogance are not grateful. But we honor you tonight with humble hearts. We join David in Psalm 124. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, we would have never made it. Thank you for all your help in our lives. Everything we have, you gave it to us. Our health, our homes, our loved ones, everything we have, you gave it to us. Stretch that elbow all the way up. And we tonight, we commit to a life of gratitude. We commit to a life of appreciation. We commit to a life of gratefulness in the name of Jesus. And we will not get tired of giving you the praise, giving you the glory, giving you the honor. And then we know that no weapon formed against us shall be able to prosper. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Somebody ought to say amen. I'm grateful. Oh, in your living room, wherever you are, just throw your head back and say, I am grateful. Oh, can you do it one more time? I can't hear. I hear somebody out there. Say, I am grateful. Oh, I hear you. One more time. Help the preacher out. Say, I am grateful. In Jesus' name we pray. Oh, can we do it one more time? Right there in the room, Mom. I know the kids are around. Right there with your family, sir. Just throw your head back and say, I am grateful. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen, amen, and amen. God is a good God. Would you welcome Minister Jordan Simpkins tonight as he ministered to us? We are so grateful, and we appreciate all that you are in our lives. Thank you, Lord.
Come on, I just want to praise God this evening. Joe, can you light us up? Man? Come on, go ahead and put on your post. We about to praise God. Check it out.
One can set a thousand. Two can set 10 G's. I praise God with all that is in me. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. One can set a thousand. Two can set 10 G's. I praise God with all that is in me. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. The difference between our music, we make that bomb music. We make that God music, sit back and ride to it. G-Unit, I got a unit of G's. Sick with the flow like a puking disease. And would you believe, we spitting in the devil's face. Rhymes just burning like a whole can of mace. I flow for God like a rhetoric reverend. Cause I'd rather store all my treasure in heaven. That's where we're heading now. Pressing on the mark, God save the lost, God get their heart. If we live Christ, he'll draw all men. So I raise my hands till I'm gone coughing. One can set a thousand, two can set 10 G's. I praise God with all that is in me. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. One can set a thousand, two can set 10 G's. I praise God with all that is in me. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God.
Yeah. You better tell somebody tonight that they better give God praise, that they better worship God, that they better give God thanks in all that they do in Jesus' name. In Matthew chapter 19 and verse number 26. But Jesus beheld them and said unto them, with men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible. It is possible today for you to give God thanks. Even in the situation, even if your situation looks bleak, even if your circumstance looks dark, you can give God thanks, because your appreciation and your thanks can change the heart of God in your circumstance. Your appreciation and your thanks in your circumstance can change the heart of God and allow God to help you through all that you're going through. So we ask today, Lord God, that you bless us, God. We give you the thanks today, Lord Jesus. We don't sit there and get down on ourselves. We don't sit there and get down on the circumstance. We don't sit there and get down on the things that make us sad or make us depressed, God. But we lift up our spirits and give you thanks because we have life. We give you thanks because we have purpose. We give you thanks because we have a destiny. Destiny, God, you have a perfect work in order, Lord Jesus. And I pray, Lord God, that you work it out, God. All things work together for the good of those who love you and are called according to your purpose. So today, God, allow your purpose to unfold, God. Today, God, allow your purpose to manifest, God. And we just give you the thanks ahead of time, Lord Jesus. I got an ahead of time faith, God. My faith is ahead of the people of today. My faith is ahead of the people thinking of today. My faith is ahead of those that are stuck in today, God. My faith is ahead of those stuck in sadness. My faith is ahead of those stuck in depression. My faith is ahead today. And so we look to ahead, God. We press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling, God. There's a prize coming in due season, Lord Jesus. So we give you the thanks, God. There's a prize coming, Lord Jesus. And we bless your holy, righteous, and magnificent name, God. You came, Lord God, that all men might have life and life more abundantly, God. So we call in your life, God. We call it in the life, Lord Jesus. We call in the life, Lord God, in our circumstance, Lord Jesus. We bless your name, God. I pray for anybody that's sick, God. Anybody that's sick, Lord Jesus. Heal their body, God. We pronounce life over them, God. We pronounce life over our children, God. We pronounce life over our marriages, God. We pronounce life over our finances, God. Lord, bless us today, Lord Jesus. We receive all that it is that you have for us, Lord God. So many other times, Lord God, we rejected it, God. But we no longer reject you, God. We draw nearer to you, God. We draw nearer to you, Father. We draw nearer to your love, God. We draw nearer to your power, God. We draw nearer to your authority, Lord Jesus. And we ask, God, that you bless us, God. We give you the thanks today, God. We are grateful, God. We love you so much, Lord God. And we appreciate all that you have done, Lord God. If we have done anything that is not like you, God, we repent for our sins. You blot out all of our transgressions, and you wash us through with the blood of the Lamb, God. And we thank you, Father, for all that you've done, God. Draw us nearer to you, Father. Help us to be grateful, God. Help us to show gratitude, Lord God, in all that you have done, Father. We bless your name. With God, it is impossible. With man, it is impossible. With God, all things are possible. With man, it was impossible. But with God, all things are possible. With you, it's possible for us to make it. With you, it's possible for our businesses to grow. With you, is it possible for our families to be lifted up. With you, it's possible for our finances to go forward. In Jesus' name. And we love you, God. And we bless your name today. In Jesus' name we pray.
Oh, thank you for the anointing to pray. Thank you for the anointing to pray. Thank you, Father, for the anointing to pray. God is a good God. He loves us, and everything is going to be all right. We just thank you for watching. Share the video. Call somebody and tell them, God is, put a comment on the screen. God is a good God. He loves you, and everything is going to be all right. Thank you for all your help. Minister Mimi Harris is going to lead us in prayer. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Thank you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. I'll be reading from 2 Corinthians 4 and 15. All this is for your benefit, so that grace that is reaching more and more people may cause thanksgiving to overflow to the glory of God. Father, we thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Father, because you are God, Lord. We thank you, Father, from the rising of the sun to the going down the same, Father. We thank you because your name is worthy to be praised, Father. Father, you're worthy to be praised, Father. Father, you're worthy, Jesus, and we thank you, Father. We thank you for what you do in our lives, Father. We thank you for the blessings that you have bestowed upon us, Father. Even the things that we don't deserve, Father. We just thank you, Father, because you see fit to bless us, Lord. Lord, you see fit to provide for us. You see fit to cover us, Father. You see fit to protect us, Jesus. Lord, and we thank you for your provision, Lord. We thank you for your outstretched hands to us, Lord, Father. We thank you because you say yes and amen to us, Father. And we just thank you, Father. Father, we thank you for all the things that you are doing in our lives, Father. All the things that you are doing in our church, Father. All the things that you are doing in our family, Father. Father, we just want to be grateful, Lord. We just want to have a grateful heart, a heart of gratitude, Father, for the things that you have done, Father, because you have done great things, Father. You have done mighty things, Father. Father, you have done things we can't even wrap our minds around, Father. Father, things that you haven't even shown us, we want to thank you for them. We thank you in advance for the things that we have not seen, Father, because we have not seen your works complete, Father. Father, so we just thank you, Father. We thank you as we move forward into this new day, this new season in our life, Father. We thank you because you have given us a spirit to praise you, Father, to lift you up, to magnify you, Father, to glorify you, Father. We thank you because you have not given us a spirit of fear, Father, but of sound mind, Father. We thank you, Father, because you have given us all the things that we need to move the gospel forward, Father. We thank you for the opportunity to come before you in prayer, Lord. We thank you for the opportunity to read your word for, Father, to get in your word, Father. We thank you for the hearts of thanksgiving, Father. We thank you for the heart of gratitude, Father. We thank you and we ask you to forgive us for those times that we failed to be thankful, to be grateful, Father, because it is in you that we move and that we live and have our being, Father. So we just thank you, Father. We thank you on today, Father, for the things that you have done, Father. We thank you for our daily bread, Father, and we're asking you right now in the name of Jesus for nothing but just thanking you for everything, Father. Thanking you for the God that you are, because you have shown yourself strong and mighty for us, Father. And we thank you for that. We thank you for your healing power, Father. We thank you because, God, without you, we can do nothing. But with you, Father, all things are possible. So, Father, we thank you for possibilities, Lord. We thank you because you've opened doors and you made ways, Father. Father, we ask that you just continue to touch us, continue to bless us, and continue to give us a heart of thanksgiving so that we may glorify you and magnify you, Father, and lift your name on High, Father. And it is in Jesus' name that we pray these things that we're asking of you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. God is a good God. We appreciate all of his love. We are grateful. We have a heart of gratitude. Just know that everything is going to be all right. God is a good God. At this time, Minister Darren Nidio is going to come and lead us in prayer. We're just so glad that you're tuned in. Don't touch that dial. God has a word for you through our prayer ministry. Thank you, sir.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. I'll read out of 1 Chronicles 16:8-13. It says, "Oh, give thanks to the Lord. Call upon his name.
Yeah.
Make known his deeds among the people.
Say it, sir.
Sing to him. Sing psalms to him. Talk of all his wondrous works.
Yeah.
Glory in his holy name.
Glory.
Let the hearts of those rejoice who seek the Lord. Seek the Lord and his strength. Seek his face evermore. Remember his marvelous works which he has done, his wonders and the judgments of his mouth. O seed of Israel, his servants, your children of Jacob, his chosen ones." Praise the Lord. Oh, Heavenly Father. Father, we come to you tonight, Lord God, just giving you thanks and praise and glory and honor. Father God, I thank you for waking us up this morning in a righteous spirit. Father, I thank you this morning that you and you alone called my name, and I came forth this morning to behold your glory.
Yeah.
Father, we thank you, Lord God, for the breath of life today, God. Lord, we thank you, Father God, for our children, Lord God. We thank you for our spouses, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, for your goodness and your mercy and your grace, God. Father, we thank you that you own a cattle on 1,000 hills, God. And Lord, that you are our help, God. We thank you that we can call on you, God, and you answer our prayers, God. Even in the midnight hour, God, we thank you that you answer us, God. Father, I'm so grateful, Father God, for all that you've done in our lives, God. We thank you, Lord God, for the first line workers, Lord God, who are dealing with the coronavirus, God. We thank you, Father, for your healing power, Lord God, for those who have walked out of the hospitals, God. We thank you, Father God, for your comfort, Lord God, over the families, Lord God, who have lost loved ones. Father, we thank you that you are still a comforter, God. We thank you, Lord God, that you have sent your son, Jesus Christ, Lord, that we could be healed by his stripes. God, we thank you right now, Lord, for you are good all by yourself. Father, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for your goodness and your mercy, God. Lord, I'm so grateful, Father God, that you made a way out of no way, God. Thank you for the deliverance of our children, God. Thank you, Father God. Lord, we're so grateful, Lord God, that you are still the God that sits on high and looks down low. God, we thank you. And we love you. We give you praise and we give you all the glory and all the honor, God, because you are so good. You are so good. Lord, I just want to say thank you, Lord God. Lord, I'm grateful, Lord. I'm grateful, God. I'm grateful for all that you've done for me. I'm grateful, Father God. Lord, let us be grateful for your wondrous works, God. Let us be grateful for your wondrous works, God. Lord, let us not get complacent, Lord God. Father, we thank you, Lord. Lord, you are so good. And your mercy endures forever, God. So, Father, we just thank you.
Thank you.
Father, we thank you. Lord, we give you praise. We give you glory. I give you honor, God.
Yes.
Because you're so good. Lord,
thank you.
We just thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, I thank you.
Thank you.
Lord, I wake up every morning, Lord God, just to say thank you.
Thank you.
Lord, that I'm able to see, God. Lord, that I'm able to have the breath of life, God. Thank you for purifying the air around us, God. Lord, that the death angel of corona just passes by, God. Oh, God, I thank you this afternoon, God. And I give you praise and I give you glory. Lord, I love you with all of my heart. Lord, we love you, Lord. And we give you praise and we give you the glory and we give you all the honor. Because you are good all by yourself. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Praise you, the Lord. Praise you, the Lord. God is a good God. Thank you that the death angel will pass over. We receive that prayer he prayed. It will pass over. Somebody put that on the screen. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Put it on the screen. The death angel will pass over your home, your job, your family, your children. It will pass over. Somebody say over. Say over. Over. It will pass over. In Jesus' name we pray. This time, Carmel Simpkins is going to come and lead us in prayer. We just thank God for his goodness and all of his mercy. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. We praise God that when he left earth, he did not leave us comfortless.
Yes.
I'm reading from John 16 and 13. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth.
Yes, he will.
For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, that you have already provided a way of escape, God, that all we have to do is call on you, and you will show us the way to go. Order our steps according to your word, God. Direct our lives in the name of Jesus, God. We give you the praise. We give you the honor. We give you the glory. We are thankful. We are grateful, God, for who you are in our lives, God. Thank you for how you're moving in our lives, God. Thank you for how you're making a way in our lives, God. So we give you all the praise and honor and glory that is due unto your name. As we gather together, we are in agreement that you are great and greatly to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, you are greatly to be praised.
Praise
so we honor you today. You're the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. You are all things, and we honor
praise
you tonight. We praise you tonight. We thank you tonight. We are grateful for who you are. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Oh, grateful. Somebody say grateful. We are grateful for all your help, all your blessings in our lives. Thank you for tuning in tonight. God is a good God. And just know it is time to pray. This is the season to pray. This is the season to read God's word. This is the season to pray it back to him. And he'll bless your life. He will help you. He will strengthen you. He will lead you and he will guide you. If you've never accepted Jesus Christ, we offer him to you tonight. It's the greatest decision that you could ever receive. When you accept Jesus Christ, there's a power that comes into your life. There's a power that comes into your life. And he will help you to overcome every habit and every hobby. He was hung up for your hang-ups. It wasn't the nails that held him to the cross. It was the love that he had for you. Don't live your life a sinner. Don't die a sinner. Give your whole heart to Jesus. Raise your hand with me, I say, and everybody say it with me. Say, Lord, I give you my whole heart. I thank you. I confess with my mouth, and I believe in my heart that Jesus died for me. I am saved, sanctified, and full of the Holy Ghost. I am empowered by God. In Jesus' name I pray. Somebody ought to say amen. At this time, Elder William Harris is going to lead us in prayer. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness in our lives.
Psalms 121. It says, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is the shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth, even forevermore. Father, we just thank you today. We have a heart of gratitude, Lord, because you help us every day in every area of our life. Lord, you help us, oh Father. We lift our eyes to you, Lord God. You're our help, Lord God. You made heaven and earth. You made everything, Lord God. You made the remedy for coronavirus, oh Father. Lord, we look to you right now with a heart of thanksgiving, with a heart of gratitude. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, you won't sleep, Lord. You will neither slumber nor sleep because you're our keeper. Oh God, you're our sustainer. You're our help, Lord God. You're our salvation. In the name of Jesus. Lord, bless those that are watching tonight. Go into their homes, oh God. Preserve them. Keep them, oh God. Oh Father, help them in the name of Jesus. Help them with their children. Teach your children, Lord God, to be gratitude, Lord God. Help them be thankful and grateful to to you, oh Father, in the name of Jesus. During this time, Lord God, you're our help, you're our keeper, you're our sustainer, you're our power, Lord God. We look to you, the author and the finisher of our faith. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
We praise you. We praise you. We praise you for all your goodness. We praise you for all your blessings. We praise you. You are our help and our shield. We look to you as our source of total supply. Thank you, God, as a good God. Don't forget to put up, let the redeemer of the Lord say so. So make sure you put on the screen, he's my help. Oh, when you know where your help comes from, you can overcome anything. When you know where your help comes from. David said, I look to the hill when cometh my help. All of my help comes from the Lord. God is a good God. Thank you for tuning in to our Wednesday night Facebook Live service. We are so glad that you're there. We just hear you out there. God is a good God. We know that everything is going to be all right. I hear somebody say, I'm grateful. I hear somebody saying, I am thankful. I hear somebody saying, I appreciate God. I hear somebody saying, the Lord's been good to me. If you are, that's you, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Oh! I hear you saying, the Lord's been good to me. Just tell him, keep telling him over and over and over. Lord, thank you for everything. Just thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And once you do that, God will bless your life. And tonight I want to say thank you and that we appreciate you. We are grateful for you, for those of you that have given to the work of the Lord. We appreciate you. Some of you have given. You have been consistent. You in your faith. There are four ways you can give at Emmanuel Christian Center. You can give by just mailing it in. And it's on the screen. But not only that, you can give by text giving. But not only that, some of you give by just dropping it off at the church. And sometimes some of you have given by going to the website. I just want to say thank you. Help me shout, thank you. Oh, help me shout it again, thank you. Thank you for all that you've given to keep the house of the Lord going forward. We're going to get beyond this coronavirus, and God is going to help us. God is going to bless us, and God is going to give us favor. We're going to get beyond these days, and we're going to look back and see the hand of the Lord, how he protected, how he cared for us, and he's going to take care of you and your family. And your children. Thank you. Thank you. You take care of God's house, he's going to take care of your house. And I just want to say thank you. I just want to say thank you. Thank you. And may the Lord give it back to you 1,000 times more. According to Deuteronomy 11:1. I'll make you 1,000 times more and I'll bless you. May the blessing of the 1,000-fold blessing come upon your life. Thank you. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto Aaron and his sons, saying on this wise, you shall bless the children of Israel, saying unto them, the Lord bless thee, the Lord keep thee, the Lord make his face to shine upon thee, and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. And they shall put my name upon the children of Israel, upon the families of Emmanuel, and I will bless them. Father, thank you. You said that you'll lift up your countenance. In other words, you're going to smile upon us. God has smiled upon us. God is smiling upon us. And we just thank you. May the Lord smile on you, on your family, on your children, on your daughter, on your son. May the Lord smile on you and bless you. And you go forward with all the strength of the Lord. Don't feel no ways tired. He brought you too far from where you started from. Nobody told you the road was going to be easy. Yes, we'll have to fight some devils. Can't believe he brought us this far to leave us. I have hope in tomorrow. I have faith in tomorrow. I believe in tomorrow. Because God is on our side. God bless you. Get your microphone. Everybody get your microphone. We're going to call on Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh!
Jesus.
As we close tonight, call his name. When you lay in your bed tonight, before you close your eyes, call on his name. Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh!
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
Oh!
Jesus.
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus.
Come on, let's call him
Jesus.
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 Oh.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Mary's baby.
Jesus.
The lily of the valley. Call him
Jesus,
somebody.
Jesus.
The rose of Sharon.
Jesus.
Call him somebody.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
Oh.
Jesus. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.